Cosi fan tutte was written in 1790, a year before Mozart died. It's one of his last great masterpieces. It's also the last collaboration that he had with the great librettist Lorenzo da Ponte. Both of them were responsible for two other wonderful operas, La Nozze di Figaro and Don Giovanni. So actually, Cosi is the last of their trio of their masterpieces. And in a way, it's very obvious that those two people were looking at their character from a vantage point of older, more experienced human beings. There's this great understanding of humanity and also a hint of cynicism in the way they look at all the people that they create. And when I was preparing for this specific production, I went back to his wonderful letters and all the many biographies that one can get about Mozart. And one thing that occurred to me that I never realized before is one of the most traumatic events in his life happened at the end of the 1780s when he passed through Mannheim and met the Weber family. The Weber family had four daughters, all of them opera singers. And Mozart madly fell in love with one of them, Aloysia, who at the beginning liked him very much and responded in a positive way, but when he came back from another trip, completely rejected him. Not 4 years later, he got married to her sister, Costanza, and had a very happy, we think, marriage with her. Yet at the same time, he continued to write the most beautiful music that he ever wrote to the other sister and the most wonderful roles. And if you look at Cosi and at the sisters and the friends who fall in love with the other sister, that I think tells us something very deep about Mozart himself and about ourselves and the choices that we make in life. We updated it to the turn of the previous century, the end of the 19th century, the beginning of the 20th century, the Gilded Age, or also known as the Age of Innocence. One movie that inspired us a lot was The Age of Innocence by Martin Scorsese, that is based on a wonderful book by Edith Wharton. It's a time period that was just after the industrial boom, and a lot of wealthy, privileged society existed in America. I'm very happy to return to Indiana University for my third collaboration with Professor David Higgins. Previously, we did here Faust last year, and before that, The Magic Flute. And this is a very special production for both of us, not only because it's another Mozart masterpiece, but also because this may well be David's final opera production here at the Jacobs School of Music after many decades of creating wonderful productions here. So it's a sad farewell for all of us. I'm also very excited about collaborating with my friend, Maestro Arthur Fagen. This is our first collaboration at Indiana University. We know each other and worked before many times at the Atlanta Opera. And we will actually meet again a little over a month from now, working again in Atlanta on a new production of Lucia di Lammermoor.